The professional bull riders is the fastest growing sport in the world, but now you can be more than just a fan. The PBR and the American Bucking Bull Incorporated has made it possible for you to own your own bucking bull. Welcome to Backseat Buckers. Let's roll.
Backseat Buckers is a program that the ABBI and PBR put together to help fans to get more involved in bucking bulls and to actually own and buy and go to events and enjoy the bucking bulls like us contractors get to.
The sport of PBR is such a great professional sport. It's neat to see how it's grown. The fan base has grown so much. And if you're a fan of the PBR, a true fan of the PBR, and you love the bucking bulls so much, which I know a lot of people out there do, this is an opportunity where you can be a bull owner.
It allows the common fan of PBR to get involved with bucking bulls. And it's not just a one-year program where you get in there and you get to compete and then it's all over with. You actually own the bull.
I have been a bull riding fan for a really long time, and I am a co-owner with my brother, Mark, and he's also a bull riding fan, and we're even fantasy players in the bull riding, and so we've been watching bull riding a really long time, and we decided, I think we want to own a bull. So we started checking out the Backseat Bucker program, and we liked it, but that's what got us started, is we've just been bull fans.
Anybody in the world can go to BackseatBuckers.com and sign up. Hook it up right there, be a part of the Backseat Buckers.
It gets you right in the back door. You see how the bulls are raised, and you get to get with them. And anybody that's interested, I would surely jump on the wagon now.
You own this bull. It is your bull. It's not our bull. We're taking care of it like it would be our bull. But you pick what bull you like. You name it. Learn how to flank the bull. You can actually flank that bull at these certain Backseat Bucker events, which is great because last year there was a lot of owners that were fans that got to get up there, flank their bull at those certain events, and be a part of watching that bull buck at a competition.
R. Wacker, 87.5 points in the number one spot. We total up this morning. How about 90.25? I think some of you liked that calf, did you?
Backseat Bucker program takes care of that animal throughout its two-year-old year. You get to watch your bull buck and have a chance to win big money.
It's a lot of fun. Meet a lot of people from all over the United States. And it's like, he's like, can't wait for the next event. You know, you get done with one, you get home and say, God, I wish that was this weekend. Had a lot of fun at the last one.
Just meeting all the people that I think now all these other people in the Backseat Bucker programs are going to be like just lifetime friends that we've made. And it was just a lot of fun, and everyone just supported everyone. I mean, no matter if you lost or you won, there was so much support. And I think that's what made it just a really great program.
All of us stock contractors that have facilities and cows and breeding programs, we all sell to the Backseat Buckers. It's an outlet for us.
So, Russ, where do all these Backseat Buckers bulls come from?
Man, they come from all over. Obviously, Oklahoma, Texas is kind of the main place for raising bucking bulls. But we're going to pick some up, I think, from J-Dub today. And then we've got, you know, Brad Boyd's always got a bunch of them in there. H.D. Page, Cliff Wiggins. So some of the best are obviously raising these bucking bulls.
These guys can get into some of the best genetics going.
Yeah, exactly. And they're all DNA tested and ready to go and registered with the ABBI, so you know exactly what the sire and dams are on all these Backseat Buckers. And do your homework and watch the videos, Buck, and go buy you a bull. We have all 70 of these bulls to look at online, which you can study them through the 1st of February all the way up to that sale, the very first of March. If you kind of know your bucking bull or think you might know your bucking bulls pretty good, you go to that website and watch all these bulls buck. But you go to the sale, the draft sale there, and we auction off the number one draft pick. So we don't just auction off each bull. Right off the bat, we go number one draft pick we auction off, which is a cool concept of the whole sport.
You know, just look for those calves that have a lot of action, that get up off that ground, has some kick up over their head. And of course, you probably want one that spins pretty hard, but that's where the research comes in of those bloodlines. You may see a video of a calf that didn't turn back right there in the gate that maybe went two or three, but if you look at him careful and study those bloodlines, you may figure out, you know, with a couple more trips, practice trips, that he's going to get better in time, and that may be the sleeper of the whole group.
We'll give you plenty of opportunities to talk to contractors and other breeders about their bulls and to get you a good bull picked out. You can pick them by color, shape, size, mean, gentle, however you want them. You know, we can get you one picked out that will fit what you want.
What I looked for in picking the bulls for 2013 is I was more the genetics person. So I was looking at all the bull genetics more than how they actually bucked. That was kind of secondary for me. My brother, Mark, did more of looking at the bucking. And then we both kind of just put our lists together and had our bulls in an order for the auction.
Do your research, look at those calves, and find the one that suits you, that you like, and build a pecking order of them. You know, that this is your first pick if you get the first bid, and so on down, if in case that calf may be gone by the time you get the bid in. The guys that take care of these bulls, Dean Wilson, Scott Accomozo, and Ross Coleman, Scott's got a first-class facility where they stay, you know, and their feed lanes and the working chutes and the tubs and the bucking chutes, all first class, it's all covered.
The facility here at the Ace of Spade Ranch is one of the better facilities in the nation for these bucking bulls. We've studied and been to several different ranches and facilities and felt like we've built the safest and best, one of the best arenas in the country. We strive to really put a setup together here to make the bull's life as happy as possible. They get two square meals a day. They get a lot of human attention, and we really love the bulls here. It's part of our life and something we'll always do.
They really do a great job of working those calves through the chutes and doing the best that they can of getting them chute broke and taking care of your animal, making sure they've got the protein they need, make sure they've got their hooves trimmed the way they need, making sure they're tipped properly, and they do a really good job of doing all that, and I've been impressed the job they've done, because they've got 50 or 75 of them standing there to take care of. And you can be assured when your animal goes there that they'll be taken care of. I've been really pleased with it.
We pretty much start over. We break them all back down. We take them back to square one as far as chute breaking and handling and training. And just bring them from the beginning to right where they need to be. Some of them will already be there, but they're going to go through it again, because we want to make sure all those bulls are on a level playing field. So when the first event comes around, everybody's bulls in the same position. They've been getting the same feed, same vitamins, same everything, and try to keep it as fair so the best bull in that program that day wins.
We know for a fact that all these bulls that are in this program are going to be legit bucking bulls, and they're going to go ahead and kick and spin and try hard. And when we get them here training on them, we're going to put the very best, the hardest work we can to make them be successful and let them give you a good ride.
My three goals were perfect body score, perfect handle, and great in the shooting arena. And that was where I wanted to get every one of the bulls. And we feel pretty confident that we accomplished that.
When you do get your backseat bucker, there's going to be different events throughout the whole year. At each one of these four stops, there's a way to win good money at each one of these events. But then also, when you go to Vegas, that's where the big money is.
This year, we're going to Tulsa for sure, and we're going to Tulsa, Oklahoma. We're going to Springfield, Missouri. There's built Ford Toughs at both of those events that people will get to experience along with their backseat bucker event. And then the finals, so that's when it gets real fun.
This is the one and only backseat bucker.
That's going to pay over $100,000 this year, and when you put that kind of money up, whether you're Chad Ochocinco or Joe Blow from South Florida, it doesn't matter. It means a lot, and everybody gets a little nervous, and it's intense.
all these events and we're not placing real good and stuff. And we're doing then the final event, it's like, bam, Papa Louie scored a 90 and it got us real excited. And we had more bulls to go, so you're trying to count down the bulls to make sure that your bull stays in the five.
They're the top five bull there in Vegas. They get to go downtown to the Thompson Mack Center and buck during the PBR finals, where you, again, the owner, will get to come back there on the bucking chutes of the PBR finals, flank the bull if you'd like to, and hopefully cross your fingers and maybe you'll have a good day out there.
So we go now to the bull that is going to currently in the lead.
Papa
here it
Louie.
Is.
Get to get down on the floor of the Thomas Mack behind the chutes. And it's exciting when they announce Papa Louie winner. And Ross Coleman, like, let's go, we got to get on the stage.
And to be on the stage at the World Finals with the winning bull, I mean, I am still on cloud nine. It was like just the most wonderful experience. Totally unexpected, but just so much fun.
The neat thing about Sharon and her brother last year were they didn't dip into that top level of bucking bulls like some guys would, like, go in there and try to buy the best available during the sale. And Sharon and them did their research and asked some pretty good questions to the right people and got a couple good bulls picked out and ended up winning it and not having to invest the money that Gary Long did the year before. He went in and picked the best bulls and bought the best bulls and won it. And then this year they went in and went for more of a sleeper type bull and then actually won it. So it doesn't take, you don't have to have a lot of money to play in this deal. You can win from the bottom, you can win from the top. That was really neat last year. Experience that the backseat buckers will provide is second to none. There's, you know, it's a very, very inexpensive way to get, you know, great access to the PBR.